X button and the square button at the same time to drive in reverse to the circle. To look back, press and hold the L2 button. The arrow indicates the location of the circle. Do it now. Okay. To steer your ATV, press left or right on either the left analog stick or the directional pad. Press and hold the X button to drive to the first circle. Then use the left analog stick or directional pad to steer your ATV to the left. Then continue driving toward the second circle. The arrows indicate where to go. Now go for it. Nice! The next objective requires you to take a jump, pitch the ATV forward, and land as level with the ground as possible. Press and hold the X button to take the jump. When airborne, press forward on the left analog stick or directional pad to pitch your ATV forward. Make sure you land as level with the ground as possible. The arrow indicates the location of the circle. After you land, drive straight to the circle to complete the objective. Good luck. Nice! Busting a stunt requires you to get some big air first. When airborne, use the triangle button or the circle button in combination with the left analog stick or the directional pad in any direction to bust a stunt. You can also use the L1 button in combination with those buttons to perform even crazier stunts. Press and hold the X button to take the jump. When airborne, press and hold the triangle button and press the left analog stick or directional pad in any direction at the same time to bust the stunt. Make sure you let go of the triangle button well before you land so you don't wreck. After you land, drive straight to the circle with the arrow to complete the objective. Give it a try. Well done. Some jumps might seem too hard to make, unless you use preload. By preloading your ATV suspension, you can get even bigger air, which will usually help you tackle complex rhythm sections much easier while shaking. Preloading is easy. Right before you reach the base of a jump, pull back on the left analog stick or press the down button on the directional pad. When you're about halfway up the jump, quickly snap the left analog stick forward or press the up button on the directional pad. Done correctly, your ATV will sail through the air even further, and soon, you'll be making those jumps you didn't think were possible. This is it, the final objective. To help see if you're preloading correctly, check out the preload meter at the bottom right of the screen. It will show a blue bar when the conditions are right to preload, and it will show an orange bar to indicate how much preload you have achieved during the jump. Press and hold the X button, and right before you reach the base of the jump, pull back on the left analog stick or press the down button on the directional pad. Then halfway up the jump, quickly snap the left analog stick forward or press the up button on the directional pad to preload your ATV all the way to the landing ramp. After you land, drive straight to the circle with the arrow. Try it now. You can do it. Great work. You've just unlocked the secret to getting the most out of ATV Offroad Fury 2. You've unlocked these Ravage Talons. Congratulations, and thank you for completing the training course.